Hey guys, welcome to our channel TechnoSavior. So in today's video I'll be giving you a code walkthrough of how to use WebSockets. So before starting, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, then please do so that you stay updated with the technical videos. If you want to know more about WebSockets and how it works, check out this animated video in the top right corner. Okay, so as you can see, I've created a basic skeleton of the application in which we are going to use WebSocket. Don't worry about the code. You can download the code from Git and the Git link will be available in the description box below. So in the index.js, I have used express package to start the node server. Setting up the app is easy, just call the express function. So app is listening to the port 4200. So now we have our server setup done. Whoever is connecting to this port needs to see some content. So we have our HTML files in the website folder. Contents of this folder will be rendered. Inside the website folder, there is our index.html file. It is a very basic HTML file. The focus point here are the socket.io in the script section. This will help us to connect with the WebSocket, and the chart.js file, which will help us in emitting and subscribing events to the WebSocket. Now in the chart.js file, there are two main events. One is the click that gets triggered whenever a button is clicked. Second is the key press event listener, which gets triggered whenever we press some key in the keyboard. This is a plain vanilla JavaScript and HTML code. No WebSocket logic is still added. Let's see them in action. So just type node index.js. Okay, our server is up and listening to port 4200. Localhost 4200. Okay, so here is our chat application. And if we quickly inspect it, we'll see some messages in the console. So basically if I type biswa and hello, and if I send, so you can see we get a message displayed, and here Biswa is typing. These messages are nothing but the console output that we have added in the chat.js. So we'll quickly come over here and we'll see. So we are creating a message object and we are just logging it. Similarly, whenever any key press happens, we are just logging this. As of now, this application is doing nothing. It's just adding the message that we typed to the console. So if I open one more localhost 4200, if I type any message hello, it does not come to this application because they both are not connected via sockets. So we'll quickly start integrating the socket in our application so that all the terminals start receiving the messages that the other terminals are sending. Okay, so moving back to our code. Now first of all, we need to enable the socket connection. So for enabling the socket connection, I have to use this. So now we have started using the socket. Okay, so we don't need to log this message. We need to emit this event to the other terminals. For that we can use socket.emit, and we need to add an event. What kind of event it is that we are emitting? We are emitting a chat event, and here we need to send the message. Okay, so I'm sending the message details over here. So after doing that, we need to clear the message section. So what we can do is we'll add message.value equal to empty. So whenever the key is pressed, we don't need to log it, first of all. Secondly, we need to emit an event that lets the other terminal know that someone is typing a message. So for that, we have emitted an event called typing, and there we are sending the handle.value, which will tell the other terminals that this handler is typing some message. Okay, so we have emitted the events, but the point to note over here is our server is not set up to receive these events. So we will go back to our index.js and we'll start using socket to receive these events. So we will enable this line so that it starts using socket. Next, we need to monitor whenever someone gets connected to this socket. For that, we will use this line. Okay, so we are monitoring if anyone is connected to the socket. So inside this method, we'll start listening to the events. So first we need to listen to the chat event. Okay, so we are listening to the chat event. We can, first of all, what we can do is we can console.log this data. So we are logging the data in the console and we are telling that, okay, the chat event is received at the server end. So again, we have one more event to listen, that is the typing event. So this is the typing event. Okay, so here once the client emits an event of typing, the server here catches that event. And the server gets to know that someone is typing something, but it needs to inform all the other clients. So first of all, let's see whether this works or not. Okay guys, so here we are using IO, so but IO is not defined. So first of all, we need to make that connection. So we need to set up the socket. For that we have to use where IO equal to socket and the server. So now our socket is set up. After that we can start listening to the events. Node index.js, as you can see, it started listening on port 4200. Now let's see what happens whenever we type some message in our chat box. Now whenever I type Biswa, hello, send, we'll see at our server end what's happening. So as you can see, we have received various console messages from the server side. Note, this is not at the client side. Okay, so server is listening, server received a message that someone is typing and it needs to inform all the clients. So this event got triggered and the server was able to catch this event typing, which happened at the client side in the chat.js. Okay, and as soon as we clicked on the chat at the end, we can see a log that chat event has triggered at the server and we need to notify all the clients about this event. So what has happened right now is, as you can see from this PowerPoint image, client has sent the message to the server. The server has received it, but it has not yet emitted this information to other clients. So again, we don't need to log this, it's unnecessary for us, but we need to emit this event to all the clients that are connected via this WebSocket. So for that we can just use io.socket.emit and which event it is, and we'll be forwarding the data to the clients. Similarly here also we don't need this, and we will be emitting this to the other clients. So now the server has received some messages from one of its client and it is emitting this information to all the other clients that are connected to the server. The server has emitted the information to all the clients, but the clients also need some mechanism to receive it. So the clients also needs to listen to these kind of events. So we'll go back to the chat.js. This is our client. So here we need to add some events that will start listening to the socket emitted events. So this is the first event. So we have started listening to the chat event at the client side. Similarly, we need to listen to the key press event. Just copy and paste it. Okay. But on listening to this, it needs to update its web page. So as you can see in the output window of the chat, I am adding a message that a message was sent by this guy and the message is this. Similarly, we need to update the web page so that it also sees this key press event. So we'll update the feedback.innerHTML that this guy is typing a message. Okay. Okay, as you can see, our server is up and running. So I put these two applications side by side. What I'll do is I'll start adding the messages. Biswa, hello, Bulbul, send it. And as you can see, both have started receiving the message. Here the handler name is suppose Bulbul. Hi Biswa. As you can see, both have started receiving messages. Whenever Biswa is typing any message, basically the chat application should reflect that someone is typing or Biswa is typing a message. It's not reflecting. Let's go back to the code and check why is it not reflecting. So this is our client.js site and we are listening to an event called key press. But if you see, we have emitted some event called typing, but we are listening to key press, which is wrong. So we need to listen to this event and we'll save it and we'll restart the server. So we'll type Biswa again and hello. So as you can see here, it quickly reflects Biswa is typing a message, Biswa is typing a message. So I send it here. Now Bulbul, hi Biswa. So as you can see, it has started reflecting. So you can see how easy it was to set up this chat application, this complex chat application, using WebSocket so easily. So in this PowerPoint slide we can see what exactly happened. So first the server received a message from one client and it captured it and it emitted this event to all the other clients, and this was possible only because it was using WebSockets. So before completing this video, there is one more thing that you might have noted. So when Biswa is typing a message, This window should not be displaying before it's typing the message. Rather, the other windows should be displaying before it's typing a message. So for that, we just need to change one line of code. So in the server side, instead of emitting this event to all, we'll be emitting this event only to the other machines who are supposed to receive this message. So we can achieve it by doing this, like socket.broadcast.emit instead of io.socket.emit. Hi. So as you can see, here it is not showing Biswas typing a message. Rather, here it is showing Biswas typing a message. Okay guys, so hope you enjoyed this session. Go ahead and create your own secret chat applications and stay connected. And if you like this video, hit the like button. Thank you.